Hello students, let's start with a new topic from the chapter Thin Cylindrical and Spherical Shells. That is the concept of maximum shear stress. At any point in the material of the cylindrical shell, there are two types of principal stresses, namely circumferential stress or hoop stress and a longitudinal stress. So now the circumferential stress is given by the equation sigma 1 is equal to Pd by 2t, and the longitudinal stress is given by the equation sigma 2 is equal to Pd by 4t. Now the circumferential stress x along the circumference, while the longitudinal stress x parallel to the axis of the shell. The two stresses are tensile in nature and are perpendicular to each other. So now the maximum shear stress, that is tau max, becomes sigma 1 minus sigma 2 divided by 2. So this becomes Pd by 2t minus Pd by 4t divided by 2. So taking LCM over here, this becomes 2Pd minus Pd upon 4t multiplied by 2. So the resultant is Pd by 8t. So now the maximum shear stress, that is tau C max, is given by the expression Pd by 8t. Important notes: if the thickness of the thin cylinder is to be determined, then the expression sigma 1 is equal to Pd by 2t shall be used. If the maximum permissible stress in the material is given, the stress should be taken as the circumferential stress, that is sigma 1. And while using the equations, the units of P, sigma 1 and sigma 2, that is ratio, circumferential stress and longitudinal stress, should be same. They should be expressed either in Newton per mm square or Newton per meter square. Also, the units of D and T should be same, that is the unit of diameter of the cylindrical shell and the thickness of the cylindrical shell should be same. They may be in meter or millimeters. So the third point is of utmost importance, because while solving the problems, you need to make sure that the units are similar. Thank you.